Good morning, dear students. This time we are going to start up with GK, class 7. Okay, chapter number 11, Trees of India. In this chapter, we are going to read about the variety of trees. So you have to learn why some variety of trees are famous. Okay, here is the first question. A banyan tree in the Acharya Jagdish Chandra Bose Indian Botanic Garden near Kolkata is believed to be over 200 years old. Okay, if you can't able to see it clearly, you take out your book as a reference, page number 16. Okay, so a dash tree in the Acharya Jagdish Chandra Bose Indian Botanic Garden. This famous tree is in Acharya Jagdish Chandra Bose Indian Botanic Garden, where it is near Kolkata, and it is over 200 years old. Which is the tree? Tree is banyan. Now you have to learn the things like this. The tree which is 200 years old, located in Acharya Jagdish Chandra Bose Indian Botanic Garden, is dash. It will be banyan. Okay. So banyan tree in the Acharya Jagdish Chandra Bose Indian Botanic Garden near Kolkata is believed to be over 200 years old. So it is a fact, interesting fact about the tree, that this tree, particular tree, is about 200 years old. Another question. Gautam Buddha meditated under a dash tree. It will be P-I-P-A-L, people tree, and became Bodhi or the enlightened one. Okay, so it is people tree. Coming on to the next question. Dash is the national fruit of India. You have to name the national fruit of India. So it is obviously mango. Okay, so dash is the national fruit of India. It is mango. Mango is the national fruit of India. Okay. Now, number 4. Dash are evergreen conifers with needle-shaped leaves and are native primarily to northern temperate regions. You have to give the name of this evergreen conifer. The name is pine. Pines are the evergreen conifers with needle-shaped leaves. Okay. Now, another question. Question number 5. Native to Australia, New Guinea and parts of Indonesia, dash tree is famous for the commercial production of oil and timber. For the commercial product of oil and timber, it will be eucalyptus. E-U-C-A-L-Y-P-T-U-S, eucalyptus tree. Okay, note it down fast. Answers were also being given here. Answers were also being given to you. So not to worry. You write your answers by looking into the answer script only. Okay. So native to Australia, New Guinea and parts of Indonesia, this tree is famous for commercial production of oil and timber. Timber means wood and oil means oil. So from which plant we take out oil as well as timber? It is eucalyptus. Okay, eucalyptus tree. Okay. Another question. Karnataka is one of the largest producer of dash. Yes, I think everybody knows the answer. One of the largest producer of this type of tree, it is sandalwood. S-A-N-D-A-L-W-O-O-D, sandalwood. Sandalwood is famous in Karnataka. Okay, so it is the sandalwood that is one of the largest producer in this state. The state is Karnataka. Okay. Now, question number 7. Dash tree is also called margosa. You have to name that famous tree whose another name is margosa, and the name of the tree is neem. So, neem's another name
is margosa. Okay, neem tree is also called margosa. Number 8, dash tree is found in central and northern plains of India. Flowers and fruits as well as leaves are edible. Edible means which you eat. So it is mahua. Mahua tree is found in central and northern plains of India. Flowers, fruits as well as leaves of this tree are edible, which you can eat. So these are famous questions of this chapter, trees of India, mind you. Okay, trees of India. Now moving on to the next page, chapter number 12. We have man's best friend. Here we are going to read about some of the famous varieties of dogs, because dogs are considered as man's best friend. Okay, your first question, it is not chapter number 12, it is chapter number 13. Chapter number 12 I will discuss in live class. Okay, so chapter number 13, man's best friend, believed to be the oldest known breed of domesticated dog. It is one of the oldest breed of domesticated dog. You have to name this famous breed, and the answer is Saluki, S-A-L-U-K-I, Saluki. Okay, kindly note it down, Saluki. Answers were also been given in your answer key. Okay, so you take it out from there if the answers are not visible over here. Okay, now another question. This dog with a wrinkly short muzzled face and curled tail. Short muzzled face, curled tail. Become extremely popular in India after starring in a series of advertisements. So this famous dog comes in advertisement also, right? Yes, that is none other than your pug, P-U-G. It is a breed of dog which comes in your Vodafone or Hutch advertisement, right? Yes. Third question. Domesticated in the Orient, it is referred as Songshi Quan in Chinese. In China, the name of this dog is Songshi Quan, meaning puffy lion dog. You have to name the dog. It is Chow Chow. Okay? That's why Chow Chow or Chowmi name has came. Okay? So Chow Chow, domesticated in the Orient, referred as Songshi Quan in Chinese, which means puffy lion dog. Moving on to the next question, number 4, it is used as a messenger and guard dog during the two world wars. This famous dog has been used as a messenger as well as it has acted as a guard dog during the two world wars. It is a Rottweiler. Okay, R-O-T-T-W-E-I-L-E-R, Rottweiler. You can see the pictures also clearly from the book. Okay, it is Rottweiler. Now another dog, this famous small dog named after a state in Mexico. So it is named after a state in Mexico. It is the smallest breed of dog. This dog, breed of dog is smallest. The name is Chihuahua. C-H-I-C-H-U-A, Hua, H-U-A, Hua. Chihuahua is the famous name of this dog. Number 6, the most popular breed of a dog in the world. This dog, very famous dog. Yes, it is famous worldwide. Labrador Retriever. L-A-B-R-A-D-O-R, Retriever, R-E-T-R-I-E-V-E-R. If you have any confusion in spelling, are written over here also, so you can find it out. Okay, Labrador Retriever. Okay, yes. Moving on to the next page, continuing on with the same, man's best friend, you have seventh one, as also known as disability assistance, search and rescue, police and military role. So this famous dog works as for military roles. Moreover, search and rescue, that means police dog, you can say. It helps police in too much work, okay, in various activities. So name of this dog is German Shepherd, G-E-R-M-A-N, German Shepherd, S-H-E-P-H-E-R-D, German Shepherd. Another question, amongst the tallest breeds of dogs, it is nicknamed as a gentle giant. It is Great Dane, G-R-E-A-T, Great D-A-N-E, Dane, Great Dane it is. Okay, Great Dane. Moreover, the fastest breed of dog that can reach speed of around 70 km per hour. This dog runs with the speed of around 70 km per hour. Greyhound it is, G-R-E-Y-H-O-U-N-D, Greyhound. Number 10, mainly used as a carriage dog in its earlier days, it is easily recognized by its spotted coat. See, spotted coat is there, right? Very famous dog, Dalmatian, 101 Dalmatians everyone has read, okay? It is a very famous dog, Dalmatian. Now, question number 11, often depicted in films as a ferocious guard dog, ferocious, very dangerous guard dog. It is an intelligent, alert and tenaciously loyal companion. It is Doberman Pinscher. Here is a picture, beautiful picture of Doberman Pinscher. Okay, everyone look at it carefully. Very ferocious guard dog, acting as a guard dog. Okay, yes. Now question number 12, large working dog from Western Alps. It is a dog of Western Alps, used in alpine rescues. So it is Saint Bernard. Okay, Saint Bernard is the name of the dog that worked as a alpine rescues to save the alpine. 13th one, this breed has a very strong jaw. This breed of dog has a strong jaw and a powerful bite, ideal for hanging on to large prey. This dog has a very strong, powerful bite. This is Boxer, okay? And last but not the least, very popular as a pet, it is a scent hound trained primarily for hunting hare. It is Beagle, Beagle dog it is, okay? Beagle is the scent hound trained primarily for hunting hare, okay? It hunts hare especially, okay? It is Beagle dog. So this is about chapter number 13, okay? Moving on to the next chapter. Rodents. Rodents, what are rodents? Yes, those animals which generally eats grains or, yes, these are rodents, okay? Rodents. Here are some of the famous rodents. You have to just name them by identifying the picture as well as by their characteristic. Like first one, this chiefly North American creature resembles the squirrel. So you have to name this creature which resembles like squirrel, having distinct strips on its body and head, exactly looking like squirrel. It is chipmunk. Chipmunk, C-H-I-P-M-U-N-K, chipmunk, okay? Number 2, it is small, short-tailed, thick-set rodent related to voles, found in Arctic tundra. So this is usually found in Arctic region, in Arctic tundra. It is a rodent related to voles, okay? Voles, it is like a round shape, okay, related to voles. It's small, short-tailed, thick-set rodent found in Arctic tundra. It is lemming, L-E-M-M-I-N-G, lemming, okay. This animal is the largest rodent in the world. This is the largest rodent in the world. It is native to South America, animal is largest rodent in the world. It is the largest rodent of the world. Okay, it is found in South America and live in large groups. It is capybara. Number 4. This little animal here you can see number 4. Refer to page number 20. Okay?
Yes.
This little animal is very common household pet. It is particularly known for its ability to learn and remember a particular path. It is Guinea pig. G-U-I-N-E-A. Guinea P-I-G pig. Guinea pig is the right answer. Okay? This slow and round rodent is covered with quills. Quills means spine. Okay? Very famous. You have also seen it in your home. Covered with quills. It usually lives on the land but sometimes also dwells on trees. It is porcupine. Okay? P-O-R-C-U-P-I-N-E. Porcupine. Yes. Number 6. I think it is the last rodent. Yes. This creature is found in North and Central America. This creature is found in North and Central America. This burrowing rodent is an expert at making tunnels. So it is expert of making tunnels and resemble honeycombs. Gopher. Okay. G-O-P-H-E-R. Gopher. It is expert in making tunnels. Tunnels? Big surang. Okay. So it is expert in making tunnels and it resembles honeycomb. The tunnel appear like honeycomb. Okay. It is gopher. Okay. Now coming on to chapter number 15. Environmental pollution. You have to just select the right answer. Right? Yes. Now the first one, environmental pollution. The emission of which of these gases causes acid rain? Sulfur dioxide, carbon monoxide, hydrogen sulfide, methane. These four options are over there. Okay. So the emission of which of these gases causes acid rain? It is sulfur dioxide. You might have read in your science chapter also that it is sulfur dioxide which combines with carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide and other gases. Okay. For the emission of acid rain. Okay. So it is sulfur dioxide, the gas which is responsible for causing up of acid rain. Another question. Which of these is a climate pattern that describes the unusual warming of surface waters in the eastern tropical Pacific Ocean? That means, which of these is a climate pattern? You have to give a climate pattern that describes unusual warming of surface waters in the eastern tropical Pacific Ocean. You have to just give that phenomenon. The unusual warming, heating up of surface water in eastern tropical Pacific Ocean is due to which of the phenomena? El Paso, El Nino, El Nina and La Nina. It is El Nino. It is this climate pattern because of El Nino, the unusual warming of surface water takes place in eastern tropical Pacific Ocean. So if there is warming of ocean water, surface ocean water in Pacific Ocean, okay, then it is just because of the phenomenon of El Nino. Always remember, because of El Nino, there is the unusual warming, or you can say the heat generated in the surface water of ocean in the tropical Pacific Ocean. Okay, clear?
Yes.
Four options are over there, so you also get an option in the papers if the question will be asked like that. Okay? Yes. Now, third question. Which of these scatters sunlight directly back into space? Of these materials, this is an interesting fact here. Which of these scatters the sunlight? It has the capability of scattering the sunlight directly back into the space. It is aerosol. very harmful for environment. Aerosol is present where? In your shaving creams, in your deodorants, right? This aerosol is present. This aerosol is very harmful for environment. Moreover, it has the characteristic of scattering the sunlight, reflecting the sunlight directly back into space. So aerosol reflects the sunlight back into the space. Always remember this thing. Okay. Another question. Which of these are widely used as coolants in refrigerators and air conditioner? Name that famous coolant of refrigerator and air conditioner. If your air conditioner gives you cool breeze, cool wind, and if your refrigerator is also very cool, it is because of this element, chlorofluorocarbon, CFC. Okay, it is the chlorofluorocarbon which is responsible for making holes in the ozone, isn't it? CFC, chlorofluorocarbon. So it is also harmful pollutant in of the environment. Another question. What makes up about 60 to 80% of all marine debris? You have to name that marine debris which makes up about 60 to 80%. Okay, that marine means water, salty water, debris waste. Okay, it is plastic, very harmful. It makes up 60 to 80% of marine debris. That means marine waste, water waste. Okay, so it is also very harmful environment pollutant. Another question. Which of these is one of the most harmful components of smoke? Out of these four elements, which of these is the most harmful component of smog? The most harmful component of smog is ozone. Ozone is harmful for smog. Okay, ozone helps us in many ways. It absorbs the harmful ultraviolet rays, right? So ozone is very useful, but it is one of the most harmful component for the smog. Smog is dust. So obviously smog is a form of dust, so it prevents the dust or smog to come to the earth. So it is the ozone layer which prevents or which is harmful for components of smog. Another question, question number 7. Which of these is not a source of indoor air pollution? Which of these is not a source of indoor air pollution? That is not the source. It is not a source of indoor air pollution. I am not asking about the source of indoor air pollution, mind you. It is not a source of air pollution. It is industrial effluent. Okay, industrial effluents are not the source of indoor air pollution. Indoor air pollution means which lies inside a room. Industrial effluent pollutes outside the room, you can say, right? But indoor, inside a room, it can't create a pollution. Okay, that is the trick over here. Okay. Apart from that, every material, mold and pollen, tobacco smoke, pesticide pollute indoor within a room. But industrial effluent can pollute outside the room or out open environment. Okay? Clear? Yes. Now, it's a time for your homework to note. Okay? Note it down. Pass. So, your homework will be, you have to learn these chapters only. That is the homework, as simple as that. Okay, so learn chapter number 11 to 15 homework. Okay, your homework will be learn chapter number 11 to 15. That is the only homework. Okay, though it is written in small, it will be made bigger. Okay, but you have to learn chapter number 11 to 15. It is your homework. Okay, so that's it from now. Okay, you have to learn all these chapters. That is only your homework. Time and again I am telling you. Okay, so that's it from now. Next time onwards I am going to come
with more interesting chapters. Till then, stay home, stay blessed, stay safe. Have a nice day, dear.